Hi everyone, I hope you are doing great. In this video, we will be taking a look at how to use index match function in Microsoft Excel. Today, I'll take you through three different examples which help you understand the function completely. In the first example, we're gonna learn the basic of index match function. We learn step by step how to merge the index and match functions together. In the second example, we are going to learn how to return the entire row with the index match function. And in the third example, you will see the real power of the index match function. You're going to learn how to return multiple columns and rows with only one formula.
I promise you, it will be fun. Let's get started.
With the help of index match functions, you can easily locate a specific value in the list. For example, I want to know what percentage of people in Brazil are unemployed. So I select unemployment in this list and Brazil in this list. And you can see the result. I could locate this value with the help of the index match functions. But before we start, we need to learn some basics. In this section, I have a table with different rows and columns. I want to use the index function to tell me what is in this specific cell. I type equal index. In the argument, you have to first select the range of table variables. I select this range, comma. In the second part, you have to type the row number that your cell is in it, not these rows. The row of the selected range.
Said is in row number 2.
So I type 2, comma. In the third part of the argument, you have to type the column number of the lookup value. It is in column 2, so I type 2 again and press enter. Excel shows me the value that I was looking for. But in real life, tables are not like this. They are like this. Instead of numbers in the headers, they have titles. So for the index function, you need to find a way to convert the position of row and columns title to the number. For solving this problem, we need to use the match function. The match function returns the relative position number of a specific value in the range. In this cell, I type equal match. The first part of the argument is lookup value. For example, I'm looking for February, so I select this cell, comma. In the second part, you have to select the lookup array. February is in this range, so I select it, comma. And in the last part of the argument, by default, number 1 is selected, which is not looking for the exact match. And if your data was not in the ascending mode, you probably will get the wrong results, but we are looking for the exact match, so I type 0 and press enter. Excel shows you the number 2, which means February is placed in the second cell of the selected range. You can use the match function for the vertical range too. I type equal match. I am looking for gas relative position, comma, and I select this range, comma, and type 0 for exact match and press enter. Now, if I change the items, you can see the relative position of them in each list. In this example, I want to use the index match function to look at different values from different cells. First, I need to get the relative position number of titles. For row number, I type equal match function. And this cell is my lookup value, comma, and I select this range as my lookup array, comma, 0, enter. The meat consumption is in the fourth position of the selected range. For column number, I type equal match. This cell is my lookup value, comma, I select this range as my lookup array, comma, 0, enter. You can see that China is in the third position in the selected range. If we combine the row and column numbers, we will get the meat consumption in China. But for that, we need to use the index function. In this cell, I type equal index. I select this range as array, comma, and I select row number from this cell, comma, and column number from this cell, and press enter. Excel is showing us the meat consumption in China. If I select export in this list, you can see the row number changed to 1. And if I select Brazil, the column number will change to 4, which shows that agricultural products are the main product that Brazil exports. These row and column numbers we typed here are not necessary. You can type them directly in the index function. For example, let me copy the formula for the row number and paste it into the row section of the index formula. And I repeat that for the column number too. Alright, this function is the index match function. In this example, I want to return the whole row information with the help of the index match function. I type equal index and I select this array, comma, and I want to type the match function for the row numbers directly inside the formula. I type match and I'm looking for this value, comma, and I select this range for the lookup array. Remember, the number of rows in the lookup array in the match function should be the same size as the index array. I mean, you have to select this range. You are not allowed to select this range or this range. This is also true for the number of columns. I select this range, comma, and 0 for the exact match. And I close the parentheses, comma. For the column number, this time we want to return the entire row. So I type 0 and close the parentheses. Now Excel is showing you the sale amount for male underwear for different months. By selecting different items from the list, you can see the results for other items. Before I start the next example, please take a look to see if you have already subscribed to the channel or not. If you haven't, please consider subscribing. This example is a little different. In this example, you will see the power of index match functions. This time, I have the ID number of people, and I want to return the name, yearly salary, and age. You have to notice that the order of the titles in this section is different from the main list. Anyway, in this cell, I type equal index and I select the entire table as array, comma. For row number, I type a match function. I am looking for the ID number, so I select these cells, comma. Lookup array is the range that ID numbers are in it. So I select this range, comma. 0 for the exact match and close the parentheses, comma. In the column num section, I want to return the name, yearly salary, and age columns. For that, you need to enter an array in the column section. Remember, the array always should be between two brackets. So I open a bracket and I want the name column. It is in the column 1, comma. Yearly salary is in the fourth column, comma. And finally, age in the second column. And I close the bracket and press enter. Now Excel is showing you the correct results. You have to notice that we type the formula only in one cell, and other cells are getting their results from that cell. I want to add another number to the ID number section. For example, I copy this ID number and paste it here. Now, I want to drag the formula from the above cell to this cell, but there is a problem. You can't do that because the selected cell is an array. Let me show you a solution for this problem. You need to convert the ID number cells to a table. I select the ID number range and press Ctrl T. The Create Table window opens. Make sure that my table has header is checked and press OK. I don't like the tables format, so let me remove it. It is better. Now, if I add another ID number to the list, Excel automatically refreshes the data.
I hope this video was useful. Please don't forget to subscribe, ring the notification bell, comments, and like. I see you next video.